In terms of the number of personality traits required to describe personality, at the upper end there is Raymond Cattell's 16PF measure, which describes 16 personality factors. The PF stands for personality factors. Cattell thought that there were 16 source traits that produce what we observe in behaviour. This is just an example of how someone might score in those 16 dimensions. Cattell arrived at that through factor analysis. Then there's Neil McRae and Paul Koster's Big Five, which says there are 5 factors to personality. This is probably one of the more popular measures for research and sometimes for recruitment as well. This is based on a different set of words, but it's based on factor analysis as well. According to the Big Five, personality consists of 5 primary dimensions. Neuroticism, described as tense and moody. Neuroticism is a good predictor of a range of mental illnesses. Extroversion, described as social and lively. Openness, which is intellectually curious and unconventional. Agreeableness, friendly and easy to get along with. And conscientiousness, careful and responsible. The measure that gets used to assess these 5 dimensions is called the NEOPI. So NEOPI stands for Personality Inventory. It consists of 181 items. People can take the test themselves and rate how much each of the items applies to them. Or they can also rate how much the items describe another person to measure the other person's personality. Now, this is obviously a self-report measure. It relies on people being aware of how these items describe their personality. It can't tap into anything that might unconsciously contribute to personality because people wouldn't be aware of it. Another perspective is Hans Eysenck's. Eysenck is at the lower end of the spectrum in terms of numbers of personality dimensions. He argues that there are 3 bipolar dimensions that can be used to explain personality. The first is extroversion to introversion, going from outgoing nature, high level of activity, to shuns crowds, prefers solitary activity. They're the 2 ends of the 1 continuum. The second is neuroticism to emotional stability, going from full of anxiety, worries and guilt to relaxed and at peace. The third is psychoticism to self-control, going from aggressive, egocentric and antisocial to kind and considerate, obedient of rules and laws. Eysenck's idea was that temperament is determined by a combination of the 3 dimensions and that these dimensions relate to something that's going on in the brain. Eysenck is interesting because he's also interested in how personality is related to criminal behaviour. He was also interested in what the biological basis for personality might be. Eysenck's early work looked at extroversion as a dimension and showed that people who scored higher in extroversion had a greater need for stimulation. They had a higher resting level of arousal regulation in the brain. They desired more stimulation to experience positive emotions. Essentially, this means that people who score high on extroversion tend to do things that are more stimulating. So they might go skydiving because that produces a lot of stimulation. Also, Eysenck found that there was a correlation between extroversion and the tendency to be involved with the criminal justice system. People who score high on extroversion tend to do things that are stimulating and risky, like break into houses and get into fights, because they produce a lot of stimulation. People who score low on extroversion don't tend to do those things.